Steve.
Oh.
Steve, you know I'm not allowed to help you. It was made very clear.
What do you make of this?
Did you not just hear me?
Well, you're a private detective now, aren't you? I'm allowed to hire external agents.
Okay, well, what's this about?
Well, I'm sure you've heard of the serial killer. This is one of his latest achievements. And just like the other ones, small fingerprints, doors and windows locked from the inside. Yet, a lifeless body has taunted our best detectives.
What makes you think I can solve it?
Well, you've always been unorthodox in your ways.
Maybe a little bit too much.
You know, I played it with him.
Who was it? The victim?
It was James Mulberry, a food manufacturer or something.
Do you think that could have done it?
No, call me when the fight's open.
Sorry for your loss.
Oh, don't be.
Are you okay if I start?
That's why you're here.
Okay. This is Lexi for Entrepreneur Magazine interviewing Rachel Botkin about her former associate, James Mulberry. How far back do you go?
Oh, quite a while. We had a group of people. He's the one that really kick-started our careers.
In the food business?
Well, mostly fruit, seeds, plantations. We owned a lot of land in Africa, importation, that kind of stuff.
Was he difficult to work with?
He was the kind of guy that couldn't take no for an answer. He came under fire a lot recently, actually, for his unethical practices. Abysmal wages for farmers. He kept trying to get the bottom line as low as possible. There were talks of lab involvement, genetically modifying plants to grow more yield.
Well, genetic modification isn't that different from crossbreeding cuttings. How's that unethical?
Yes, but the science wasn't always... He never claimed he did anything illegal, but I didn't believe him.
And did he have any enemies? Anybody that would want him dead? Jealous competitors? Crazy exes?
I suppose, in a way, we all became competitors. But we respected each other. I don't think any of us would have... It wouldn't surprise me if he had any enemies, though. You don't get that far to the top without making some.
Steve?
I told you to call me. Did you find anything?
Yeah. This Mulberry character, he wasn't as popular as we thought. He was like any other greedy corporate arsehole. He used to treat his workers like shit to reap the rewards.
Don't say that too loudly. The government might be listening.
Seriously though, this is weird. It seems he was bumping off the competition. He got killed shy by one. I don't think Rachel Botkin is capable of murder though. And it still doesn't explain how the murderer got in. Have the autopsy reports come back in yet?
I don't believe he has. I'll chase that out for you. What are you going to do now?
I think I'm going to head back to the crime scene, see if anything else comes up.
But you will need a key for that. Oh, detective, do you happen to know if we have the autopsies for Mr. James Mulberry yet?
No, I don't think there was one.
Why did you murder those people?
No, I didn't, I swear!
No sign of entry, no sign of exit. Yet you could have sneaked in, unnoticed. Why did you murder those people?
Isn't that jumping to conclusions?
All of them work for the fruit industry. You had the perfect motive. Killing them to save your own skin.
Yeah, well, maybe, yeah, maybe I had to.
So you admit it?
Lexi! Out now!
No, I'm getting somewhere.
Out!
What the bloody hell do you think you're doing? Have you gone completely insane?
It sounds crazy. I know. But he was just about to tell
me... It's a bloody banana. The other detectives were right. I shouldn't have got you on this case and I want you off it now.
No. You can't.
I bloody can. I'm in charge. Now go.
Yeah, what about the banana?
I'll bloody take care of the bloody banana myself. Go.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Yeah, Rachel Botkin. Okay, we'll be over in like 10 minutes.
Shit.
Yeah. Oh, I gotta go.
Lexi, maybe it wasn't wise for you to come back. You know, with your mental health, this was bound to happen again. You know, it was me who reported you in last time. I do care about you.
Rachel, answer the door, please.
Well,
oh, it's you. I did the interview, though.
It's okay, I'm not a reporter or a private detective. I think your life's in danger, but it looks like you already know this.
Sorry.
It's okay, it's okay. Give me the knife, Rachel.
Potassium. Lethal doses of potassium. That's what the murder weapon was. And guess what? The banana's gone.
So you believe me now?
There's no time for that. Where are you?
I'm with Rachel Botkin.
All right, stay there. I'm on my way. I'm on my way.
Okay. Stay right there.
No! He's gonna understand!
Lethal doses of potassium is what killed that group, and now you're here to finish off the job.
James Mulberry made me.
You had a choice.
No, I mean he literally made me. I was an experiment who went wrong and he used me to remove the competition or he would kill me.
So you did it to save your own skin?
No, I used that joke earlier. Oh, sorry. So, why did Mulberry die?
Well, no, I made a mistake. So I tried to find the notebook.
This notebook?
Yes, I thought it would have the answer in it, but then
I found you. So why are you here now?
I'm here to protect Rachel!
Protect from what?
Protect from... Oh, Max! Oh, God, no! No! No!
No!
Yes, me.
James Mulberry?
He did, in fact, inject me with potassium, but he didn't account for my prior exposure to lab chemicals that reacted to it and saved me, albeit in a new form.
James, you don't have to do anything.
Of course I do. You know far too much. And while I have your attention, Chief, how nice to finally meet you.
Steve?
I'm sorry, Lexi. Sit down. You trained my man on, Detective. You are one of the best.
Oh, please. I was never good enough in your eyes. There's always Lexi this, Lexi that. I tried so hard, damn it. Just because you were in love with her.
What? No. I'm not really into Lexi, like, no offense.
Oh, no, not taken. I'm not really into him either. He's not my type.
So what?
I mean, you're a guy.
Oh.
Ah.
What are you getting out of this banana anyway? I hope it's not a milkshake.
It's not about the money. It's about the principle. And also, I was promised a lot of money.
And what exactly do you want?
Ah, I'm glad you asked. I would like, firstly, the domination of the fruit industry. And I can achieve this with ultra-competitive prices, mostly from outsourcing.
What about the notebook you've been answering? Oh yeah, the answer.
Paid in exposure they will receive from our social media managers, we can get them high up on Tic Tacs. Then of course I'll sprout away from the fruit industry and into the vegetable industry. Something I've only dreamt of, but is possible now with the army of bananas at my side. Nothing will stop me!
Nothing, are you sure about that? Now, that is what I call a banana split. That's not funny. Someone's just died. This whole experience has been so unappealing.